hiding under the landing gear compartment is one of the numerous ways people try to escape poverty by risking their lives. And this is what happens to people who hide under the landing gear compartment of an aircraft that is flying overseas. It's your aviator, Captain Austin, and I'll be discussing about some unusual events that happens during flight. Airplane stowaway are people that have tried to escape to other countries by sneaking into the landing gear compartment of an aircraft just before takeoff. In US alone, the Federal Aviation Administration has documented 113 cases. Some of them were traveling alone, while some of them were traveling in pairs. But one thing is common, they were all searching for a better life. Now, looking at the records, we found that they were all males and below the age of 30. But why would anyone take this desperate measure? They believe that that is the only way out of their despicable situation back in their home country. But unknown to them that they risk the possibility of having hypothermia, hypoxia, and also the possibility of falling down from the wheel of the landing gear when the aircraft is taking off. Talking about hypothermia, as the aircraft climbs into the sky, it experiences a temperature drop. And for every 1,000 feet, it drops 2 degrees. At 33,000 feet, which is normally the cruising altitude for most commercial flights, it must have dropped as low as negative 60 degrees Celsius, and this will cause a severe hypothermia. And mind you, the landing gear compartment is not pressurized, so there is no vent, no heat, except that giant hole where the landing gear extends. Oxygen level and the atmospheric pressure will also drop so low that every normal human being would need an artificial pump in order to operate his lungs. At this altitude, the body experiences hypoxia, which is complete lack of oxygen that will lead to visual impairment, complete weakness, and lack of consciousness. However, there were cases where people didn't even make it to the high altitude because the landing gear crushed them at the point of retraction immediately after takeoff. But there were still slim cases of miraculous survival, but with severe consequences. Of those 113 people, according to FAA, 86 of them died. That is a fatality rate of 86%. That means 3 out of 4 people that will run away from their country as stowaway are going to die. As we can see, the odds are never in their favor. Even when they manage to land, which is almost impossible, the country where they arrived will never welcome them with open arms, pat them at the back for pulling through, or grant them citizenship. They would rather slap them with a huge fine, imprison them, or deport them back to their country immediately, because boarding an aircraft as a stowaway is illegal in all countries. Another unusual event is Birdstrike, which is of utmost concern to the airline industry and the military. When a bird or flock of birds hits the aircraft, it can cause a serious damage which can have a disastrous consequence. A good example is the one that happened on July 15, 2009. The US Airways flight took off from New York and was struck by a flock of birds 2 minutes after takeoff. Upon realizing he has lost all engine powers and he will not be able to make it to the airport, the captain decided to ditch the aircraft in Hudson River. Miraculously, the lives of everyone was saved. This came to be known as the miracle on the Hudson. A bird strike is an event that involves the collision of the bird and the aircraft while it is flying. It happens in all the phases of the flight, but mostly common during takeoff, approach, and landing. More than 1/3 of bird strikes normally occurs in the aircraft engines. The birds get sucked into the aircraft and cause compressor stall. This will lead to engine vibration and complete loss of thrust. Other areas where bird strike occur is in the windshield or the wing leading edge. Is there a solution to this? Unfortunately, there is no perfect solution to bird strike, but only a few things can be done to mitigate the effect of this problem, or better still, prevent it as much as possible. The airport authority has few methods to handle this issue. For instance, some airports have some specialized ground-based radar equipment that helps in tactical detection of large flock of birds. Habitat management, such as cutting down the trees and the grasses, can help in curbing the incidence of bird strike. We can see that bird strike events cannot be completely eradicated, but with proper planning and careful implementation programs, it can help in curbing these incidences to the barest minimum. It is estimated that average of 16,000 bird strikes occur in US alone. Although fatalities from bird strikes are rare, but it can cause considerable damage on the aircraft. In conclusion, bird strikes have always been part of aviation. While they usually cause minor damage to the aircraft, they can as well pose a threat to air safety. Being aware of the possibilities of bird strikes and by following standard procedures, flight crews have reduced the possibility of bird strikes and its effects to the barest minimum. That is it for today. It's your aviator, Captain Austin. Subscribe to my channel. Click the bell button for notification. Share and like. See you next week for another presentation. Bye.